Welcome back, everyone. Commonly used as bait, worms are very active in their preferred habitats. Winston Reed and Dr. John Long take an up-close look at red worms and night crawlers.
All right, today we're talking about two types of worms, red worms and night crawlers. This is Next to Nature. Dr. Long, we're going to start with red worms. Let's talk all about it. Tell us, what do we know? Well, we know for sure, you just told me that red worms and all worms are not native to America. Interesting fact.
A majority of the worms that we see in our area are non-native to the United States. They came from Western Europe. A lot of times when they are mass produced or grown, they're for fishing purposes. We obviously have them here. Red worms in particular like compost piles. That's where you can find a lot of them. They are a deep digging worm. So if you ever hear somebody saying, I'm gonna go dig for worms, that's what they're doing. They have to really turn the soil up or under to find those worms in particular.
Let's check out the worms we got under here.
So we've got some worms under here, and as you can see, they're fairly deep in this compost pile. And when you touch them, you can see here, that one's already headed south. So you have to really dig them out. They're a smaller worm than the other one we'll be talking about today. But red worms are fairly prevalent, and people can grow these, again, in compost piles, or I've even seen them grown in other structures, even like old refrigerators I've actually seen.
Another interesting fact, red worms, and I guess all worms, are asexual?
That's correct. There are no male and female. They contain their own, the male and female organs within the worm itself.
All right, let's head over to the oak tree to check out the night crawlers.
Okay.
All right, so the red worms are a deep digging worm. Right. The night crawlers are a shallow digging worm, correct?
That's correct. You'll find night crawlers underneath loose leaf litter, such as we have here.
Okay.
They tend to, as you said, be a shallower burrowing worm. Red worms tend to be deeper, as you said. A lot of people can be surprised by night crawlers because they're so shallow. When you rake back leaves or whatnot, they tend to wiggle. These are a little docile, but when you rake them back, they tend to flutter, so you kind of stand back. They do work the soil shallower. Red worms are deeper, so they kind of have a mutualistic relationship, unknowingly, of course. People even plant them in their garden in order to help them aerate the soil.
Okay.
To work the soil, and they're also beneficial to fishing. Typically, the smaller ones are used for smaller fish, and the larger ones are used for larger fish.
Yeah, the worms are the go-to bait for people who like to fish.
That's right.
All right, well, Dr. Long, thank you so much. Mm-hmm. This is Next to Nature. We'll see you next time.